Welcome back to the channel, ladies and gentlemen. Today we're going to be reviewing this Humvee M998 Tactical Vehicle / Desert Storm Edition. An original design by Mary Wilson.
Mary Wilson!
Yes.
She makes great stuff. She's one of our favorite designers.
Yes, she makes great stuff. Build plate, as always. Cue the time lapse. So we're about to put the canvas on, but in the instructions, bear in mind you, it says to have a gap right there, and we're going to see how it goes. You can clearly see there's a gap there, and we have a gap on the model, because Dave insisted we build that way. I wanted to put some 1x2 tan bricks right there for the time being until we get the canvas add-on, but we're going to see how it goes. Well, wasn't that cool? Alright, so... Dave, you want to talk about a little bit about the history?
Well, young Joshua, there actually is a lot of history concerning the Humvee M998 tactical vehicle.
Really?
It's the high mobility, multi-purpose wheeled vehicle, or Humvee for short. It first burst upon the scene in 1985, and it gained fame, worldwide fame, when it appeared in prodigious numbers in the Gulf War in 1991. It's still in use today with many, many variations. Has a crew of two, usually 8 passengers. It's used to haul cargo. You can outfit it with machine guns or missile launchers. It can be used for defensive as well as offensive purposes. Holds 25 gallons, has a range of about 275 to 337 miles. A maximum speed of anywhere from 55 to 65 miles an hour. Interestingly, almost all of them were built by AM General, based in South Bend, Indiana, and they actually assemble these Humvees in their Mishawaka, Indiana plant. There's been about 281,000 of these bad boys in all variations made, and the cost these days is about $220,000 per vehicle.
So this isn't going to be our mobile studio?
I want one. I need one. Now, you can sometimes find them on government auctions for pretty good prices, you know, $8,000 to $10,000, but you often have to do things to make them street legal, blah, 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 blah.
You can get them for $8,000 to $10,000?
Yeah, but they're surplus. If you're lucky at an auction, the government, when they get done with property and they get worn out or they're ready to send it out to pasture, they'll offer it up for sale at auction, at surplus auctions. And you can find all kinds of stuff, not just Humvees, but buses, trucks.
We need to go to a government auction, baby.
People do, but
sick.
I mean, you're kind of rolling the dice.
Think of the YouTube content, though. Yo, that's a sick video idea.
I suspect there's a bunch of videos.
All right, so the design about this kit. Yeah, we're going to talk about the pros and cons really quick. But I would say, for the most part, like 95% of it is great. Awesome build. I mean, 98%. Awesome, just an awesome build. There's doors that go in and out. You got 4 of those, 2 on each side. You can like kind of flip that over. And that kind of comes apart, but then you can open up the hood and pop the hood and, you know, work on in the engine or whatever you want to do. With that, it's your choice because it's Lego. You can do what you want to. The canvas add-on is optional. I guess you could take that off, but I think it looks a lot better with it on.
Yes.
There's this little hole that, you know, if you wanted to transport some weapons, you could just kind of like stick it right in there. And you can, you know, fit a couple weapons in there if you want to.
How are you gonna get that out, bro, man?
little bit of finagling and just kind of whip it right out. Boom, it's out, you know? But you can use that to transport your weapons and, you know, just your make it weapons. More accurate. Weapons.
Oh, I thought weapons. You said weapon.
Now, you can also place a minifigure in there. I've already done so with one of the minifigs, which you do not get any minifigures in this set, by the way. Now, it's a little counterintuitive of how you would think you would put a minifigure in there. You can't just put them in. It does not happen. You can't stick it in like that.
One option is just to stick him in there.
You can't stick it in like that because his helmet is too big. So what you can do is actually quite easily remove a couple of these tiles. You put it in there. You put them in like that. And actually you can put them over one more stud. There's actually plenty of room for minifigs in here, which is very, very good. And then you put the tiles back on. And you have two men in there. So yeah, it's pretty great. And actually it's very easy. And it's very sturdy. Now, one thing about the building of it, there is a gap, a pretty noticeable gap right there, and that's probably because of the design of the actual vehicle, probably does have something like that, but when you're building it, it makes it actually very hard to build this back section. So what you're going to want to do is build all this separately. So in the instructions where it tells you to put it on, don't put it on and build up that little section and then put it on. It's going to make your life a whole lot easier when you're building this kit. But that's literally the only problem. Everything else is great. The design is so sleek, so awesome. It just looks dope. All right, it just looks dope. I don't know what else to tell you. It looks dope. I literally like the use of these ingot pieces on there. That is great. There's so many great parts uses. There's a little bit of printing there. A little bit of printing. Not a ton,
Painted grill hood.
There's a three
and a windscreen
printed parts.
Panel.
Yep.
And a canvas covering is the other custom part or piece to this.
And honestly, that right there, believe it or not, it's printed. It does not look like it, but it's awesome.
Yes.
Because it integrates so well with this. All right, let's talk about price point, shall we? Price point. Now, to be clear, you do not get the minifigs, you do not get any weapons, no brick arms elements, you just get this canvas add-on right here, and then all the bricks to build it. So anyway, you're looking at what you get here, minus the minifigs. And Dave, you wanna talk about that?
It's $105.
Which is very reasonable.
249 Lego and Brick Mania pieces, including some printed pieces, as we've...
What's the price per piece ratio to that?
About 25... Well, you would ask me that. 30 cents a piece? A little over 30 cents a piece?
That is insane value for a Brick Mania kit. Like, Brick Mania. How? Why have you not done this with everything else? I'm sure probably the parts, tan parts, aren't as expensive as a lot of other parts, like dark bluish gray. But still, that's really reasonable, honestly. I mean, that's only 20 cents better if you got a Lego kit. Which, when you're talking about custom Lego stuff, this is insane value, honestly.
I think so, too. This is absolutely one of the nicest, best bang for your buck Brick Mania kits I've seen.
You can be rough with this. I mean, don't go throwing this around your yard.
Dave, seriously, don't do this. Don't do this. Don't do this. Don't do this.
Or going and throwing it into a window or something. But, you know, if you accidentally drop it when you're playing it, you can play with this, actually. It's that good of a kit. So I'm going to probably title this video the most practical, affordable Brick Mania kit there is on the market right now. Unfortunately, it's out of stock, but I think this could make a great birthday present if they come around for Christmas, a great Christmas present.
Groundhog Day present?
Any kind of present.
Millard,
I mean, this
Fillmore
is just a
birthday
really...
Millard Fillmore's birthday present?
Yeah, I mean, and honestly, I don't know if they have any Desert Storm minifigures in stock yet, but if they do have two, you can just pick up this kit, pick up two of those, and you're ready to go. I mean, this is just an awesome kit.
Yep.
Packaging. All right, so packaging. They've upped their game by a lot. I don't know how late they've been doing this, but I think this might be the first kit they're doing this, but anyway.
Or it may be just special to this because it's Desert Storm. It's got those Desert Storm
maybe
covers, but whatever it is, we really like this.
This is really cool. Very, very cool. It says Minneapolis, Minnesota, right? Up
yes.
There. Brick Mania. It has all this textured, it's actually slightly textured printing. It has still all that goody stuff, like we got number 62, which is awesome. BKM down there in the corner, just awesome packaging. We flip it up, and it's that nice cardboard. It's nice quality. It's just really good. Great kit.
I don't know what else to say. I mean,
well, like, comment.
Like, comment, subscribe, share, turn on all notifications. Let me know what other kit I should review or buy, and then we'll get David to buy it for us. No, but seriously, if you... Not the next one, but soon, Castor Roman Barracks. Oh, it's happening. Goodbye.